glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Bobby Bowden Field at Doak Campbell Stadium is the venue for today's exciting college football game. Florida State is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. From his own goal line, he's taken down at the 25-yard line. Notre Dame's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brad, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
Tackle made around the 36-yard line.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
Gets it. He's in space. He's taken down.
Right around the 44-yard line.
They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Makes the catch and look out. And he shoves out of bounds at the 41-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
To the receiver, and he's got it again. And they make the stop at the 25.
When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want them.
They'll bring him down at the 15-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll make it second and inches.
He's tackled at the 2.
Call it a gain of 13 yards. That makes it
first and goal from the 2. Let's see if they just don't try to power their way into the end zone here. Throws quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown. And he adds the extra point. Let's check in with Reese Davis in the studio.
The Demon Deacons came into the game ranked 9th after the bitterly disappointing loss. How far will the pollsters move them down? And for Wake Forest, they've dropped 2 straight. The Broncos roll by 19.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. Notre Dame lines up for the kickoff.
Anderson back deep to return.
Anderson from the 6. Tackle at the 36-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. He's at midfield. And he's tackled at the 41.
Some surprisingly good ball-carrying skills by the big fullback. If he can do more of that, this offense will become even more potent.
From the 41-yard line, first down. And he's taken down
at about the 43-yard line.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
Quick strike, and he drops it. The offense couldn't convert, and that's going to cost him the possession. Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown.
So much of the passing game is about the timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. And right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
It's an intelligent play by the defender. All you have to do sometimes is get your hand on the ball.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 37. Notre Dame up 7 points. He fights forward to about the 40. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Brought down right around the 48-yard line.
I like this wide receiver a lot. He knows where he needs to be on the field so the quarterback can get him the ball. He made a terrific play to keep this drive alive.
Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 48. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they push him out to the 37-yard line.
Gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Tight right, tight right. Four down, let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Track. If you kill it, motion me out.
Quick shot to the tight end, and he can't pull it in.
Barnes was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
From the 37-yard line, second down. Strike to his receiver, no good. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Notre Dame is up a score. Tackle at the 8-yard line.
Call it again at 29 yards. That makes it first and goal.
And he's got all the time in the world. And he's immediately tackled.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. That brings up second and goal.
All right, D, let's go. All right, D, let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown. Fine pass to get 6.
Yep, he made a good decision and threw a very catchable ball.
converts the extra point. A nice 10-play, 63-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow them down.
So the score now, 14-0. He's out to the 30. He makes it to the 32-yard line. It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Right around the 42-yard line. Nugent's got the first of what should be many tackles to come. He's a heck of a player, really explosive and quick, a sure tackler, as you can see on that one. From their own 42-yard line, it's first down. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. Tackle there in space.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
From the 43-yard line, first down. Pickup. A long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, Notre Dame's lead is 2 touchdowns. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. Carries the ball for a nice game.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs, and they're executing well. But the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with this scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
And he's level at the 32.
You keep gaining negative yards, and you put yourself in a position of having to make bigger and bigger plays. Puts a lot of pressure on that quarterback.
Second down and 11. Ball on the 32.
Three down. Let's go. Here we got Mike.
He laterals. They bring him down in the backfield.
Yes, sir. You don't want that? That makes it third and 11.
You don't want that?
This is the eighth play of this drive. Made right around the 20. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 20. Laterals back, and he's got space. Tries to get around the corner. Touchdown, FSU! He got the handoff and knew exactly what to do with it.
They like the fact that they have a halfback who can pick his way so well through defenses.
On the extra point. Florida State's got some new faces on the roster that they're expecting some big things from, partner. And, you know, that's what's great about college football. New faces every year, unexpected stars, and the newcomers are kind of splashing onto the scene. Florida State yet set to kick this one away. Hart fields it at the 3. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. They're hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Notre Dame is up by a touchdown. Fires complete over the middle. He's taken down around the 41-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 15 yards. First down.
Quick throw. And they make the stop around the 49-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. That brings up second and one.
Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
What's the run? They're running.
He's at the 40. He gets out to about the 37-yard line.
Called a gain of 12 yards. First down.
Let's go, D.
Caught, enough for the first down.
That's a gain of 13 on the ball. That makes it first and 10.
Roger, Roger. Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
They'll bring him down at the 10.
Mackey with the tackle at the 10-yard line. First down.
Throws complete, and he's hit right away.
That's a gain of 7. That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Touchdown, Irish. Pitch it, and the quarterback's able to run it in.
I'll tell you what, when you're a quarterback and the goal line is right there, it's pretty hard to pitch the ball when you think you can get in. That's a smart decision to keep it for the score.
And he hits the PAT. A nice 7-play, 74-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. But this time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback in the receiver.
So our score, 21-7. And down he goes at the 21-yard line.
Boy, the two offensive coordinators have to be loving this. In fact, you can look over at our booth next to us and see how much they're enjoying it with a big smile on their face. The defensive coordinators, on the other hand, might be looking for a pink slip on Monday.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. That's a great tackle at the 38. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big game.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 38. And he is drilled at the 46. The Seminoles taking their first time out of the half.
Roger, Roger. Let's go, let's go. Here we got Mike, number 53.
Run!
Nice run up the middle. First and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's tackled around the 32-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. Tries to buy some time. And he's tackled right around the 22-yard line.
That'll make it second and inches.
Larry, Larry. Let's go, let's go.
He's hit immediately. Johnson gains about 4 yards there.
I think they were expecting a run on that play, Brad, and it allowed the quarterback to throw for just enough yards to get the first down.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap, and he threw it right out there. Tackled for a loss.
Loss of 2 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Wilkerson picks up about 7 yards on the option keeper. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
It's fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Time to dock the boat in Knoxville. The Hokies strike through the air, getting into the end zone for a touchdown. The Volunteers have the lead, 14-7.
And for Notre Dame, wow, they got a golden opportunity now. With a win, they're going to move up in the polls this week if that score holds up. They line up to kick this one away. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Notre Dame's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
Got it, and brought down immediately. That reception good for 7 yards.
This was a nice little route here by the receiver. He took the ball in nicely and got his team a decent game.
And he's taken down at the 45-yard line. Notre Dame's going to have to use their second time out of the half. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 45. And he hits him hard at the 26-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Going for it all to the end zone. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
From the 26-yard line, second down. Deep pass to the end zone. Touchdown, Fighting Irish. He makes the PAT. A 5-play, 76-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school. Grind it out and earn the yards and just rip the heart right out of that defense.
He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. And they get nice yardage on that run. So we've played two quarters. The Fighting Irish lead, 28-10.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Take a look at both quarterbacks in this game, and neither one of them even has their pants dirty. Nobody's been on the ground here. No pressure generated by the defense, but one of the reasons is because quarterbacks have been able to get rid of the football. Maybe a little help in the secondary to those guys trying to rush the pass.
The guys up front always get the blame, but it really is a business that works hand in hand, because you can get a lot of sacks off garbage sacks where it's great coverage down the field, but the quarterback has to hold it for 4 or 5 seconds. But it works the other way around too. If somebody's open every time he pats that football and reaches the top of his drop, I can't get there in time. So the coverage needs to tighten up a little bit, mess up the rhythm, jam the receivers maybe a little bit more. Give me a little bit of time so those big boys up front can get to the quarterback.
Just about time to get you back out for the second half. Brad and Kirk will be along in just a second. You're looking forward to keeping an eye on everything around the country here. Got a good, like a game score.
We're locked and loaded. We got all the big screens going. You're going to be looking to hand out some helmet stickers later.
Yeah.
We're loaded, man.
I'll try. You think you can keep on your shoes in the second half?
I'll try to. Am I stinky?
Yes. Brad and Kirk, you're at a safe distance. Take it away.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll give it off here. He makes it to the 28-yard line. Second down at 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 28. Grabs a pitch, looking for the corner. Nice run there as they work the outside.
That's a deep 5 on the way. That'll bring up 32.
So he decides to hold on to it, and it goes nowhere.
That'll make it 4th and 2.
Williams awaits the snap. Signals for a fair catch. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Gets rid of it. From their own 29-yard line, second down.
Let's go, let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
Throws it in a hurry. Tackle at about the 39-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 10 yards. That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
And down he goes at about the 35. Motley back to return it. He's taken down the 37-yard line. Notre Dame coaches just got to be happy. I'd love to coach a kid like this.
Oh, I think these coaches love to coach a guy like this. And another great performance by him individually and for this offense.
It was a quick 3 and out on their last possession.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
He laterals. Brought down around the 39-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That brings up 2nd and 9.
From their own 39-yard line, it's 2nd down.
Mike,
number 53.
Mike, 53.
Too little.
Ready?
He tackles him for a loss. He's lucky just to get back to the line of scrimmage on that option.
That'll make it 3rd and 9.
Larry. Tee it up.
brings up fourth down.
Great stop by the defense. They played with tremendous character on those downs.
Johnson will be the return man. We're about set to start things up again. Made around the 22-yard line. Russell gains about a yard on the play.
That brings up second and nine.
Tight end right. Four down. Let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike,
check,
53.
Check out. Disco Raver. Disco Raver.
Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks.
Gain of six on the play. That makes it third and three.
He fights forward to about the 30. Barber is the punter. And he can't hang on to the ball. Tackle to 39-yard line. The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it.
Down two possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
He fights forward to about the 40. From their own 40-yard line. Let's go. Second down. They'll drop him for a loss. One more quarter to play. 28-10, Notre Dame. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four.
Let's go. And we got Mike, number 53. Mike, 53.
It's complete. He's pushed out of bounds at the 39. First and 10. Ball on the 39. He's going to try and scramble. They'll bring him down to the 38-yard line.
Gain one on the play. That brings up second and nine.
He's scrambling. He's taken down around the 38-yard line.
No gain. Third down.
Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29.
Back to pass. No Mike, 52. Mike, 52.
And he tackles him hard at the 20. From the 20-yard line. First down. And they make the stop at about the 23-yard line.
That is a loss of 3 yards. That brings up second and 13.
And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Let's go.
his man, and they take him down immediately. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. Two for two so far on this drive. He scrambles. Now he's going to run, and watch out. Decides to slide.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
That brings him second and goal.
Second down, goal to go. Ball on the five. Here's the fullback, and he's taken down behind the line. There was just no daylight on that play, and the defensive lineman was the reason.
Well, that's one way to get involved in the game. Great stop in the backfield.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. Quick throw, caught, touchdown.
You've got to give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a two-point conversion. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Two. Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese?
The Hokies entered the day ranked fourth. That is now in the past tense. How far will they fall? We've seen an upset. Tennessee grabs the W by a touchdown. In other action, the Tigers were ranked number 13. They took care of business, and they should hold their spot next week. This game was so tight, every play seemed to be of the utmost importance. The Tigers grab the win by five.
And for the Fighting Irish, I'm sure they're well aware now with that score in that they've got an opportunity to move up in the polls if they win today. Oh, he got nailed on that one. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Just under 2 minutes in the game. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Russell gains about 5 yards on the run. Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 39-yard line. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
Maybe after a nice run like that, you try to go up in the air for the play-action pass.
Around the 27-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back. Florida State will use their final timeout from the 27-yard line. It's second down. That's a great tackle at the 25. Taken down right around the 14-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 14. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He'll go down to one knee.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Four down, four down. Let's go.
Dame staff just dancing on the sideline. Their star player came through for them, and they couldn't be happier.
Well, the staff has to feel good. The entire team should feel good. And I know you and I just having a chance to sit back and watch this young man play. Just an outstanding performance and something that this entire team will be able to build on.
Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.